Good morning, students. Yesterday, history, unit 5, social and religious reform movements in the 19th century. Students, today I am going to complete this lesson, unit 5, history. Listen here carefully, students. Ramalinga Swamigal. Ramalinga Swamigal, popularly known as Vallala. He was born in Marudur near Chidambar. His family, Ramalinga Swamigal's family, moved to brother's house, Ramalinga Swamigal's brother's house at Chennai. There they lived for some years. Ramalinga Swamigal viewed that those who lack compassion on for suffering being are hard-hearted, their wisdom clouded, he said. Ramalinga Swamigal view that those who lack compassion means pity, for suffering being are hard-hearted, their wisdom clouded. He, the sympathy on all the living beings, including plants. It is called Jeeva Karunya. In this life, all the living beings, sympathy on all the living beings by the Vallala. Not only the living beings, but also plants also. So, this is called as Jeeva Karunya. He established Samarasa Suddha Sanmarga Sangam. He established Samarasa Suddha Sanmarga Sangam in 1865. It means pure truth. Insisted on pure truth. Samarasa Suddha Sanmarga Sangam insisted on pure truth. He started a free feeding for all the people throughout the year at Vadalu. His poems, the Vallala's composed many poems. The poems were known as Thiruvaruppa. His radical views, Vallala's radical views were known as Maruppa. Note it. Vaikunda Swamigal. Vaikunda Swamigal, born in Sahastan Kovil Village. He was born in Sahastan Kovil Village, present Samithoppu, it's in Kanyakumari district. Present Samithoppu, it is a Kanyakumari district. Sahastan Kovil Village is one of the village. Present Samithoppu, it is in Kanyakumari district. He was born, Vaikunda Swamigal was born. His parents, name after him, Mudichudum Perumal. His original name was Mudichudum Perumal. After that, the name Mudichudum Perumal was changed into Muttukutti. Vaikunda Swamigal not properly learned. Education was not provided to them. Vaikuntha Swami from the childhood was not given, but acquired knowledge of religious texts. More and more religious texts he learned. In his life, Vaikuntha Swamigal opposed upper caste people. Upper caste people treated lower caste people cruelly. So he condemned the upper caste people, opposed the upper caste people, and encouraged, advocated depressed people. Encouraged the depressed people. He served for the depressed people more and more during that time by the Vaikuntha Swamigal. He visited Tiruchendur temple. Tiruchendur temple he visited. At that time, he saw a vision. In his vision, he saw cruelly treated the depressed classes in that. So, he requested all rites and rituals were avoided to the people. He opposed the rites and rituals. The lower caste people were treated cruelly during that time. He opposed the upper caste people and treated lower caste people very well during that time. In his life, Vaikuntha Swamigal condemned the worship of idols. Idol worship he was avoided. And animal sacrifice also. He was prohibited by the Vaikuntha Swamigal. Animal sacrifice. He was started one organization known as Samatva Samajam. Samatva Samajam was started by Vaikuntha Swamigal. In this Samatva Samajam, he insisted interdining all the without any discrimination, all the different caste people sit together and taking meal. Interdining were arranged by Vaikuntha Swamigal. He was imprisoned on jail, put into the jail for some time. He was popularly known as Ayya. People called him as a Ayya. Vaikuntha Swamigal was called as Ayya. And the people followed the way of the Vaikuntha Swamigal. No, what idea he is given? No, that way the people were followed. That way is known as Ayyavadi. Ayyavadi. He composed many poems and written many texts. In this text were known as Akila Tirattu. Agila Tirattu. Ayoti Dasar. Ayoti Dasar was a Tamil scholar, writer, also. He was one of the Siddha medical practitioner. Siddha medicine practitioner. He was one of the Ayoti Dasar, one of the journalists. He served for the, in his whole life, he was served for the social, political activists. Socially, politically, more and more involvement during the time of Ayyothidasar. Ayyothidasar was born in Chennai. He knew the language of fluent in Tamil, English, Sanskrit, Pali languages. He well known. He was opposed to the untouchables. During Ayyothidasar time period, the depressed classes were treated cruelly during that time. The people were suffered a lot. Depressed classes were suffered a lot. So untouchables were practiced everywhere. The upper caste people treated lower caste people very hardly. So Ayyothidasar condemned this one. untouchables. He was started an organization, Ayodhidasa, known as Advaita Nanda Sabha. Advaita Nanda Sabha. In this organization, the development of depressed classes insisted. And also, the temple entry movement was started during that time. The depressed classes were prohibited to enter the temple. It was strictly prohibited by the Ayodhidasa. All the depressed classes enter the temple without any discrimination. He hardly insisted. In 1882, John Ratnam and Panditar, John Ratnam and Panditar established Dravida Kadagam. John Ratnam, 1882, John Ratnam and Panditar established Dravida Kadagam. In this Dravida Kadagam was established the development of all the people, particularly the lower caste people and the depressed class people. He was started a magazine called Dravida Pandian in 1885. Ayodhidasa started a magazine called Dravida Pandian in 1885. In 1891, Dravida Mahajana Sabha was started by Ayodhidasa. Dravida Mahajana Sabha was started. In this Dravida Mahajana Sabha, first conference was held at Nilgiri district. He published many newspapers, particularly Oru Paisa Tamilan in 1907. He distributed, circulated all the places. Oru Paisa Tamilan, it is one of the newspaper. Circulated all the places during the time of 1907-08. Ayodhidasa, influenced by Theosophical Society, the leader of the Theosophical Society during that time, Colonel H.S. Alcott, already told you, H.S. Alcott. He was influenced by the H.S. Alcott. And after that, Ayodhidasa went to Sri Lanka in 1898. And he was converted into Buddhism. Ayodhidasa converted into Buddhism. He was started Sakya Buddhist Society at Chennai. He came to Chennai after went to Sri Lanka and converted the Buddhism. Then again he came to the Chennai and he started Sakya Buddhist Society at Chennai. He was insisted Sadi Vedam Atra Dravidar Kadagam was started by Ayodhidasa. Sadi Vedamatra Dravida was started by Ayodhidasa during that time, noted, without any caste. All are equal. There is no discrimination. He insisted all the people during that time, noting. Listen here, students, once again, recall now, Ramalinga Swamigal, popularly known as Vallala, he was born in Marudu near Chidambaram. Family moved to Chennai. His brother's house. He viewed that those who lack compassion on for suffering being are hard-hearted, their wisdom clouded. All living was pity on, sympathy on all living beings and plants also. It is called as Jeeva Karunya. He started Samarasa Suddha Sanmarga Sangam in 1865. It is one of the pure truth. He insisted the pure truth. He was started a free feeding for all the people at Vadalu. All the people, free feeding were provided at Vadalu throughout the year. He composed a poem known as Thiruvaruppa. Radical views were known as Maruppa. Vaikuntha Swamigal was born in Sastan Kovil Dillai, present Sami Thoppu, Kanyakumari district. His original name was Mudichudam Perumal, changed to Muthukutti by his parents. cool education was not provided to the Vaikuntha Swamigal, was not given, but acquired knowledge of the religious texts, more and more knowledge about the religious texts he had. He opposed upper caste people and advocated depressed class people. He visited Tiruchendur temple, saw many discrimination at Tiruchendur temple. He requested all the rites and rituals were prohibited during that time. Want to avoid all the people, he insisted. And lower caste people were treated cruelly during that time. He condemned that one. And worship of idol worship were condemned, opposed. And the animal sacrifice also opposed by him, Vaikuntha Swamigal. He started an organization known as Samatva Samajam. In this Samatva Samajam, insisted interdining. All the people joined together and interdining were taken. And he was imprisoned for some time. He went to jail for many time. And his followers were called him as a Hayya. His way is known as, all the people called him as Ayyavadi. His poem was established as Agila Thirattu. He composed a poem that is known as what? Agila Thirattu. Ayodhidasa, one of the Tamil scholar, writer, Siddha medicine practitioner, journalist, and he was involved in social and political activist. Born in Chennai, fluent in Tamil, English, Sanskrit, Pali languages, he well known. Opposed the untouchables, against the untouchables during that time, and lower caste people were treated cruelly. He was opposite, and upliftment of the untouchables in his main aim during that time, Ayodhidasa said. He was started Advaita Nanda Sabha. The temple entry was not ordered, not allowed to the lower caste people during that time. It was strictly prohibited by him, lower caste people. Temple entry movement developed by Ayodhidasa. In 1882, John Ratnam and Pandita established Dravada Kadagam, where they established Ayodhidasa distribute one magazine that is called Dravada Pandian in 1885. In 1891, Dravada Mahajana Sabha, one of the organizations was started by him, and first conference was held at Nilgiris. He was presided over the meeting conference at Nilgiris. He distributed one of the newspaper that is known as Oru Paisa Tamilan in 1907. It was circulated all the places. He influenced by Theosophical Society leader Colonel H.S. Alcott. After that, he went to Sri Lanka in 1898 and converted into Buddhism. He came back to the India, and Sakya Buddhist Society was started at Chennai, and his view that Sadi Veda Matra Dravada Kadagam wanted to follow all the people. He strictly advised all the people, noted. Okay, then see you tomorrow, students.